Remember that in electrophilic aromatic substitution, the pi system serves as a nucleophilic source of electrons. And that's the highest occupied molecular orbital. And if that highest occupied molecular orbital is actually low in energy, then it's not going to be a very potent source of nucleophile. And reactions like electrophilic aromatic substitution will be very slow. Well, that's the case for six-membered heteroaromatics in which the carbon atom, or the pi system, is functioning as the nucleophilic source of aromatic of electrons. And in other words, pyridine is very much deactivated toward electrophilic aromatic substitution relative to benzene. Here are some examples. You can see that pyridine is intermediate in reactivity between nitrobenzene and dinitrobenzene, both of which are deactivated toward electrophilic aromatic substitution because of the electron withdrawing nitro groups. And compared to benzene, pyridine reacts only 1 times 10 to the minus 20th in relative rates. It's very slow relative to benzene. And in order to do an electrophilic aromatic substitution on benzene, it requires really forcing conditions, demanding conditions like fuming sulfuric acid in presence of nitric acid at a ridiculous high temperature. We're going to do a substitution reaction, electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Here's the electrophile in electrophilic aromatic substitution. The pi system is going to serve as the nucleophile. The replacement, the substitution that's going to take place, is going to be that hydrogen atom, and we're going to do that hydrogen for nitro group replacement. You can see the conditions for other kinds of substitution. Chlorination requires a very demanding, very potent Lewis acid, trichloroaluminum, aluminum trichloride. Bromination requires 320 degrees Celsius. And sulfonation requires sulfur trioxide, a very potent Lewis acid, a very potent electrophile, in order to do that substitution. So in addition to being deactivated and requiring these very demanding conditions, the substitution, as you can see, always goes in the so-called meta or three position relative to the nitrogen atom in the ring. And on the next slide, what we want to do is understand both the mode of deactivity, why the ring is so deactivated, and why the substitution goes in the three position. There's two reasons for the deactivation, and one is the electronegativity of the sp2 nitrogen atom. Recall that we had drawn some resonance descriptions in which the ring is positively charged, and if the ring is positively charged, we ought to get the feeling that it's electron deficient. Electron deficient ring doesn't make for a very good nucleophile. In addition to the electronegativity of the ring, there is the other mode of reactivity which is going to take place, and which is going to decrease the reactivity of the pi system even further. And that mode of reactivity is what we've already discussed in the previous webcast, where that nitrogen lone pair functions first as a base. It's going to pick up a proton, and that's going to take place before any electrophilic aromatic substitution would take place. And so now we have to do the reaction. We have to do the subsequent electrophilic aromatic substitution not on pyridine. That's not the reactive mode, but rather on the pyridinium cation, which is an even poorer nucleophile than pyridine is. And so in the case of a six-membered ring heterocyclic, the first thing that we're going to do is it's going to function as a base, pick up a proton, or pick up a Lewis acid, and make that ring even worse, an even worse nucleophile than it was initially. So with those two modes of reactivity in mind, why does the nitration take place at the 3 position? Well, we can draw resonance structures, and what we need to do is first consider attack at the 3 position, and what we can find is that we end up having, because we're going to start with the pyridinium cation already protonated, a dication formed as the intermediate. And we can look at the different resonance contributors and where that positive charge is located for attack at the 3 position, and we see that the positive charge is always separated. It's never on the same atom. No matter what resonance contributor we draw, we'll be drawing a pair of positive charges, but at least they'll never be on the same atom. They're separated. Compare that to the case where we attack either the 2 or the 4 position. Let's take the case where we attack the 2 position, starting from the pyridinium cation. And now we have a pair of positive charges. And notice that we can come up with a resonance contributor in which both positive charges reside on nitrogen. That double positive charge is something we never encounter in organic chemistry. It's ridiculously unstable, and we can forget about it as being important. Attack is only going to take place under forcing conditions and at the 3 position, the meta position. It'll never take place at the 4 position or the 2 position, because that would involve a resonance contributor with a double positive charge. We mentioned the pyridine N oxides, and it turns out we can actually enhance the nucleophilicity of that pi system by first putting on the oxygen on the nitrogen. And so notice that the oxygen has a non-bonding pair of electrons that it can donate into the pi system. And that enhances the reactivity and also the so-called regioselectivity for the 4 position. So if we nitrate pyridinium N oxide under the conditions of nitric acid and sulfuric acid, we do a substitution, and that substitution takes place at the 4 position. Let's try to understand why that is. If we go ahead and attack at the 4 position with our electrophilic nitronium cation, we end up with this intermediate, and it's an intermediate which has an important resonance contributor that uses that non-bonding pair of electrons on the oxygen to donate into the pi system, or ultimately into the empty orbital, empty atomic orbital on that carbocation, and we can create this nitronium cation as an important intermediate. But that's only possible if we attack at the 4 position with the pyridine N oxide. That goes on and does its electrophile dissociation step, the last step, and we end up with the substitution taking place.